I hope that's okay.
Yeah, absolutely.
Wonderful. So I think before we start, we got a minute. Tushar, Hiran, and Dani, how's it in Bombay? How are you feeling?
Like all of us now, it's the same everywhere. It's no more different. It's everywhere. It's the same thing. Sab jagah ek hi hai, lockdown. Better to stay safe. To stay bed. The best thing is you're spending time with your family. And I've just got a baby, so I'm getting so much time to spend with my baby, which is great. I think it's a blessing in disguise. So it's a good thing that this has happened for me. I'm sure it's difficult for others. But yeah, but you have to look at the brighter side of everything. That's how I look at things. So this is the brighter side for me. So to spend time with my wife and my child.
Fantastic. It's 11:30, so we'll go live now. So good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I think Tushar is...
Yeah.
So good morning, everyone. Welcome once again to the 8th episode of the Yogananda Guru series by Shulini University. We are honored today to have, I still will call him the very hit Tushar Hinanandani, while he requested me not to use the word hit. He's a very modest man. Quickly about Tushar. Tushar has been a writer in the film industry for a very long time. He's written a range of movies, from hilarious masti, grand masti, to mysterious movies like The Ek Villain, to social-related movies like San Ki Aankh, which I think he also wrote, but also movies like Half Girlfriend. And he then decided to direct an amazing movie called San Ki Aankh, which I incidentally happened to see. I had no intention to see it. I thought it was a bit of a porn movie. The name sort of sounded a little like that. But I happened to see it, and it was path-breaking. He also got the debut Filmfare Director Award for that. So
I didn't get an award for that. I got nominated for that.
Nominated for that, okay. That's also a big achievement. Yeah. So once again, welcome Tushar. We're going to hear from him, his journey from his school days to movies. We'll hear from him, his passion about movies. We'll ask you questions about, Bollywood, your journey into movies, your inspiran about San Ki Aankh, your future projects. So ladies and gentlemen, over to you, Tushar Hiranandani, the director of San Ki Aankh. We also have with us Tushar Mittal, a very dear friend of Tushar Hiranandani, because of which Mr. Hiranandani is with us today. So Tushar will also be asking some questions to Tushar Hiranandani along the journey of this next 45 minutes. So once again, thank you everyone. And my first question to Tushar is going to be something very simple. Just tell us about yourself, Tushar, and tell us about your inspiration and your journey, how you got into films. How did you become a writer? Were you always a writer or was by chance or by fluke? So tell us a bit about yourself, your schooling and your transition into films.
So I'll tell you one thing. So in my school, it's a school called St. Mary's, the cap that I'm wearing. And I'm very proud that I was in a school called St. Mary's. It was one of the best schools in Bombay. And I was a very bad student. I had dyslexic. I'm a dyslexic person. It's the same thing like Tare Zameen Pe, which you see the kids. And I don't think my parents realized that I was dyslexic. I used to really study, but I used to always fail. I've repeated my class twice because of that. Because I can't read and write. Even today, I can't read and write. But yes, whatever I see, I remember. And... because I used to fail, my parents obviously were not too happy with me, while my sisters used to be really good in studies. So whenever they used to go out in the summer holidays for holidays, I used to ask my father that instead of going out, give me money to buy see movies. Video cassettes aate the 30 rupees ke 100 tab. So I used to take membership of that or picture dekhta. And that I think got the entire thing of making movies into me, because movies always were my best friend. I used to have fun seeing movies. I used to forget about everything and watch movies, and I used to really start getting into that world. Also, another thing is that my father was a distributor, my grandfather was a producer distributor, so maybe it's in my blood also. But yeah, as I grew up, my those days movie business, even today, is a very risky business. It's one of the most risky business ever, and we had bad times. So my father wanted me to study. Like I said, I was very bad in studies, and I failed. I was not doing good. He wanted me to do CA or take a bank job or something like that, and not get into this line. But then I joined Xavier's Institute for Mass Media Communication, and that was the first time that I stood first in that entire university. That's that time when I felt that this is what I need to do. And I joined Indra Kumar, and that's how my journey started. I did my first semester. assistant in a movie called Man, directed by Indra Kumar, starring Amir Khan and Manisha Koirala. So that's how I got into the film industry.
Wow, that's very fascinating. You know, we'll talk about Man in a second. But, you know, by the way, my son is at Xavier's Bombay. So he's studying over there. So I'll tell him that, you know, we have got a famous alumni with us. Can you hear me, Tushar? Hello. I think we're having some technology challenges. Tushar, Hiranandani, can you hear me?
I think I lost you.
Can you hear me now?
No, I can hear you. I think I'm losing you.
Okay. I'll pass it over to Tushar Mittal in case there's a problem at my end.
Can you hear me?
Tushar, over to you. Tushar Mittal, over to you. I think there's a problem with my end. Let me solve the technology. Tushar Mittal, you want to ask questions?
Tushar, can you hear me? This is TM. Atul, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Go on, TM. Yeah, why don't you do it? Yeah. I'll try to sort my technology out.
Yeah, I can hear you, TM.
So about your journey, Tushar, this is fascinating. I did not know about you being the part of that movie, Man. Are you able to hear it to me? Tushar? I think we are having a trouble with the connection.
I can hear you.
All right.
Tushar.
So a couple of questions which I wanted to, you know, ask.
I can hear you.
So something I wanted to ask you, what really inspired you to make Sand Ki Aankh? Were you actively looking for such a subject or you discovered it accidentally and then decided to go for it?
Hello?
I think we're having some technology challenges over here.
Right.
Tushar, are you with us?
Yes. Tushar, Hiranandani, can you hear me?
I think we lost him.
Yeah. I am here.
It takes a while to reach to him.
So Tushar, why don't you go on? Why don't you...
Nidhi.
Tushar Hiranandani, can you hear us, please? Could you tell us?
Hello. Hello.
Yeah, we can hear you, Tushar. Tushar, are you there? Atul, can you reconnect him?
Yes, I will do that. I'll just give me a minute, guys. I'm sorry. I think he's tried to come in from his other phone. So give us 1 minute, everyone. We have him. We got Tushar.
I've come from the other phone.
Perfect.
You all have muted me, I think. You can hear me now?
Yes, we can hear you completely.
Okay, now let's do. Sorry about that.
So as you said about your movie, Man, no idea we had that you were part of that film with Amir Khan in it, and that was really long time back.
Yeah.
So one question I really wanted to ask you for a very long time, that what inspired you to make Sand Ki Aankh? Were you actually hunting for a subject or you discovered this accidentally and then really decided to go for it?
Actually, I always wanted to become a director. When I joined Indra Kumar, I didn't join him as a writer. I joined him as an assistant director. I was the last assistant director. But I was quite, actually, like I said, I'm dyslexic, but I'm very smart. I can say that. Okay. So I realized that just being an assistant director, see the movies, those days and even today, you need actors to do make movies, right? And the only way actors get impressed by you when you get close to them and you can impress them. And being the last assistant director, as in that all you would do is clap. It's something called clapper boy. So that's the worst. It's not the worst, it's the last. That's the job of the last assistant those days. And no one wanted to be the clapper boy, but I didn't mind it because you were closest to the actors. And I realized that just being an assistant is not going to happen. So I started, because I said, like, I used to see a lot of movies. And sorry, us time chori bahut karte the hum. Scenes yahan ka wahan marte the English picture se bahut kuch. Aaj bhi karte log, par nahi bolte aise. But yeah, I always say chori karte the hum. So I was very good at that. Yeah. So I started helping in the story sitting. And incidentally, Induji's couple of films didn't work. And then he was looking out for an idea, and I came up with my friend Milab Zaveri and my then partner Milab Zaveri, and I came up with this idea of Masti, and we wrote that film. And Masti, that's how my writing career started. That was my first film, and Inder Kumar gave me a break. Straight from a clapper boy, I became the writer, and I became close to actors also. And I've always wanted to direct a film, but it took me. There were 4 or 5 companies who tried to launch me, but somehow it didn't work out. Either the actors that I wanted, I didn't get the actors, or the story somehow, when I started off, I liked it, but then midway, I just forgot about it. I didn't want to do it. And then I had given up on direction. I got married and I got a job in Balaji, while my wife, Nidhi, who is also the producer on Sankhya, was working for Dharma. And we were both very happy and settled down. And I used to always joke with her that now we've made, and I was really doing well as a writer, I was really making good enough of money. And we had kept enough of bank balance left for us. Like you say, in India, mentality is like FD bana ke rakh dete side mein humare budhapan ke liye. So we had all that thing left. Hamare paas tha kaafi kuch. But I used to always joke with her ke, yaar, when I become 50, I'll retire. In fact, I used to say 45 karke, I'll retire. Now I'm 45 already. But I'll retire at the age of 45 and mem. Lunavala, which is next to, it's a hill station next to Bombay. Lunavala, mein I'll go and start kheti badi, that is gardening. And she used to always laugh. And incidentally, this is how Sankhyak happened, because that similar time, I saw this show, Mr. Amir Khan's show used to come on Satyamay Jayate, where these two dadis, Chandro Dadi and Prakashi Dadi, came on the show, and they said at the age of 60, they started living their lives again for their granddaughters, and they started shooting. And I had tears in the eyes, and my wife Nidhi was also seeing the program, and she said, "Why are you crying?" I said, "You know, even if I was joking or not joking, I thought about to retire in life at 45, and here look at these two ladies at 60 who are under so much pressure, and because of the system that they live in, because of society, they had so much pressure, but they still went ahead and started this, their lives, and they helped so many people, which is a great story." So I said, "This is, someone should make this story. Yeah, it's a great story." So she said, looked at me and said, "You always wanted to become a director, didn't you? And why don't you make a film? You should be directing this film." I said, "You're sure?" And she said, "Yes," and I'm on as the producer. So that's how Sankhyak started. All because of Nidhi.
It's amazing, Tushar. I have to tell you that as Shulini, we have a bit of a similar story. My father, he was 65. He retired and then he started Shulini with a plain passion to build a great universe. So we can associate with that. But we first have to also request him not to retire, because we look forward to seeing many.
No, I don't think I will. Yeah. No, right? Now after making Sankhyak, I don't think I'll retire.
We are thankful for that. But I'm just curious. You just said you're dyslexic. And another level, you said you were a writer. So how did you manage?
Again, I lost you.
Can you hear me now, Tushar? Sorry, I think.
Hello?
Yeah, Tushar, can you hear me?
Hello?
Yeah. Hello? Tushar?
Yeah, can you hear me?
We can hear you. That's right. We can hear you. Can you hear me?
Okay. Yeah, I can.
Yes. So, Tushar, I'm asking you, how do you manage being a writer where you have to write and still be dyslexic?
Yeah, so that's what I said, because I still have a great memory. So I have an assistant who's been working with me for donkey's years. His name is Chetan Naidu. Bichara, I really ill-treat him sometimes, but I really love him. He's one of the best guys that I've worked with. So he basically, whatever I discuss, he types it and he writes it for me. And in fact, he reads it out to me. So that's how I work. That's my process. So he's there in every meeting that I go, in every film that I do.
Lovely. So thoda sa peeche jaate hain, ab aapne movies ki hain.
Hello?
Tushar, मेरी आवाज आ रही है आपको? अगर आप आई थिंक अगर आप थोड़ा सा एक जगह पे रुकेंगे तो बेटर कनेक्शन मिलेगा.
Okay, now this should be better.
हाँ जी. So Tushar, हम थोड़ा सा आपके राइटिंग करियर पे डिस्कस करना चाहेंगे. आपने बहुत सारी मूवीज लिखी हैं, कॉमेडी है, मस्ती में, ग्रैंड मस्ती में, हाउसफुल फोर में. आपने कुछ एक विलन टाइप मूवी लिखी है जो थोड़ा जिसमें मिस्ट्री का एंगल था. आपने ड्रामा लिखा है हाफ गर्लफ्रेंड, फिर आपने सांड की आंख, एक सोशल रेलेवेंट फिल्म लिखी. तो आप इतने डिफरेंट टाइप कैसे हैंडल करते हैं एक टाइम पे? आई मीन कॉमेडी से लेके सीरियस सब्जेक्ट्स तक कैसे आप इसको मैनेज कर पाते हैं?
यार, लाइक आई सेड, आई लव ऑल जॉनर्स ऑफ मूवीज. सो एनी टाइम इफ आई हैव टू गेट कनेक्ट टू द आइडिया, द स्टोरी व्हिच आई ऑलवेज फील that the director has to give the story. So Sankh Kiyak story was by me. I chose the subject. So once the director gives the subject, I feel that is the real time I get into it. Because I am a director's writer. I always say that the director is the captain of the ship. So I always trust him and I work with the director. I don't write a single line without the director being there in the room. So jo bhi hamara story sitting bolte usko, we call that as a story sitting. So discussion happens, I always discuss with the directors. All the directors that I work with is always that way. So I sit with them and I don't believe in genres. I just believe the subject is good and has to touch me and I work on those subjects.
Extremely fascinating. तो आप movie background से थे और आप entry, हमने सुना है कि अगर आप सिर्फ background से हो तो entry थोड़ी आसान होती है. तो मेरे my son has specifically asked this question. He wants to be an actor and I think many of us have a desire to get into the movie industry. It's very glamorous. So how do you enter the industry? क्या करना पड़ता है? हमने स्टोरी सुनी है कि बहुत स्ट्रगल करना पड़ता है. तो इफ अ नॉर्मल पर्सन लाइक मी और टीएम और अदर्स वांट टू एंटर द इंडस्ट्री, क्या करें?
सर राइट है, बहुत स्ट्रगल करना पड़ता है, पापड़ बेलने पड़ते हैं बहुत. लाइक आई सेड, आई माय यू सेइंग माय डैड वाज देन इन द इंडस्ट्री, बट दैट जस्ट गेव मी एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू एंटर. आई वाज जस्ट एन असिस्टेंट. My aim was to become a director, and when I joined the industry I was 20 years old, and when I became a director I was 45 years old. So you can see the amount of years it took me to become a director. Also, after doing so many films as a writer, I got a chance to make a film. That also it took me 5 years to make my first film. Sankh Kiyak ke liye mujhe 5 saal lage. So it's not an easy process. It's a very tough process. Everyone thinks it's very easy. It's the toughest process to get a break in this industry. Yeah, but if you're talented and if you're hardworking, you will succeed. That's what it is.
I think it's a learning for all our students and everyone on this that, you know, from the outside, everything looks glamorous. लगता है सक्सेसफुल हो गए, पर उसके पीछे बहुत ज्यादा मेहनत की जरूरत है. और मुझे लगता है अभी भी आप बहुत मेहनत करते होंगे कोविड के टाइम पे. आप अपना टाइम कैसे बिताते हैं? कितने घंटे काम करते हैं तुषार? कितना लिखते हैं आजकल?
मैं लाइक आई सेड, मैंने राइटिंग छोड़ दिया सर जब से मैंने सांड किया बनाया. तो आई हैव अ टीम ऑफ राइटर्स एंड आई एम डूइंग अ लॉट ऑफ स्टफ ऑन दीस थिंग्स कॉल्ड ओटीटी प्लेटफॉर्म, जो आजकल नेटफ्लिक्स, Amazon, हॉटस्टार. तो इस सब चीजों के लिए मैं काफी कुछ कर रहा हूँ. एक सीरियल लिख रहा हूँ हॉटस्टार के लिए, पिक्चर बना रहा हूँ नेटफ्लिक्स के लिए. तो काफी कुछ चालू है. तो दिस इज आई हैव अ टीम ऑफ राइटर्स हु कीप हु हैव डिफरेंट टीम ऑफ राइटर्स हु आर वर्किंग फॉर मी, एंड माय वाइफ इज प्रोड्यूसिंग इन निधि. लाइक आई सेड, शी इज द प्रोड्यूसर, आई एम द क्रिएटिव पर्सन, आई एम द लाइक द क्रिएटिव प्रोड्यूसर ऑन ऑल दीस थिंग्स. सो दैट्स व्हाट इज हैपनिंग. एंड ऑब्वियसली माय नेक्स्ट मूवी इज जगदीप, हु रोट माय फर्स्ट फिल्म. इज अ ब्रिलियंट राइटर. इनफैक्ट ही जगदीप इज द इज आल्सो अ डायरेक्टर. ही इज डायरेक्टेड अ फिल्म कॉल्ड शड्डा and Sukhi Bindi and Sufna and Kismat. So a very big Punjabi director. He's writing my film now, my next film. So that process is on. So these days I'm not wasting my time. Because writing, we don't, like we are doing this interview. That's how I in fact meet my writers also, on Zoom or on WhatsApp chat, video call. So this is the best way to work. So it's working out really fine for me. So it's good. It's writing is going on for me.
और टेंशन आजकल बड़े लोगों को टेंशन है घर में बैठने की, उसको कैसे मैनेज करते हैं तुषार? आप तो इतने क्रिएटिव हैं, यू मस्ट बी आउटडोर, आपका तो काफी सारा आउटडोर है. तो हाउ आर, व्हाट विल यू टेल आवर ऑडियंस कि आप कैसे मैनेज कर रहे हैं आजकल? आप मेरे को, जब आप मेरी आपसे बात हुई थी आपने मुझे कहा था दैट यू आर वेरी हैप्पी एक्चुअली नाउडेज, यू नो यू गॉट अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम. सो टेल अस अ बिट अबाउट हाउ यू स्पेंडिंग योर टाइम.
सर टेंशन तो सबको है, सबको आउटडोर जाना है, पर नाउ जो ये हमारे जो कोरोना है, नाउ वी ऑल हैव टू फाइट इट टुगेदर एंड स्टे सेफ, एंड व्हाट वी नीड टू डू इज ऑल हैव टू स्टे सेफ एट होम एंड नॉट स्प्रेड इट. दैट्स द ओनली वे व्हिच इज सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग टिल वी डोंट गेट द क्योर. दैट्स द ओनली वे टू टैकल इट. सो इफ इट दिस इज द टाइम ऑफ दैट सॉर्ट वी हैव टू डू. अभी हमको ये करना पड़ेगा और हमको ये सब समझदारी से करना पड़ेगा. इट्स नॉट लाइक एनीवन इज forcing us. It is about us to save our lives. This is what we have to, if we have to live, we'll have to do this. So now I have learned it that this is what it is, then people, we adapt. Human beings adapt to all kind of situations. So I've adapted to this. So I'm not wasting my time. Instead, like I said, on my phone, I've started my work with everyone. In fact, I started inspiring my writers who were sitting at home, and I told them, don't waste time. Because once this thing ends, there'll be so much dirt of work and you have to be ready for that. So you need to be ready with your subjects. You need to be ready. So instead of wasting time and sitting and talking about this again and again and sending WhatsApp on Corona and spending time of how many people are dying, rather work and move ahead in life.
I know आपने मुझे यही कहा था कि आपने WhatsApp जो है आप सिर्फ एक घंटा देखते हैं, and that will probably be a lesson to everyone in the audience. PM, you had a lot of questions. Why don't you take over from me?
So I agree what Tushar Hinanandani is saying. He has actually
left his group. You can ask him that.
Yeah, exactly. So he put in a message that the Corona news is only negative, and right now it's only blocking creative minds. So he exited from most of his groups, focusing on his work, which I really like. I want to ask one question, Tushar. That today, social media can actually catapult a film into spotlight. It builds opinions. It creates your pre-launch hype. Sant Ki Aankh used social media quite effectively. What I want to ask you, what were the traditional marketing mediums which are now actually redundant?
Redundant would be like the earlier on used to see posters and the banners that used to be put on. I don't see that anymore, and I think that is a waste because it doesn't matter. So it has become social media. Rather than social media, another platform that I think is Twitter, Instagram, I think Facebook, and majorly WhatsApp. That's what people don't realize. WhatsApp, if you see, is the maximum things that go viral is through WhatsApp. Today, this corona has proved it that however smallest message from everybody, from you till your driver or to your person in the house or to your manager, everyone has the same WhatsApp. So it really travels fast. And if it's a good promo, see, everything depends. Today, a movie looks, the promo is the most important thing. Once they see the promo of the film, they have decided they want to see it or they don't want to see it. If the promo is interesting, they will go and see a movie. If they don't find it interesting, they will not see it. So the promo it has to hit the eyeballs. You have to get the eyeballs to see it. So I really think WhatsApp is a great medium. Facebook is a great medium. So promo is the thing. Like I said, those posters and banners don't work anymore.
I agree.
एक सेकंड सांड की आंख पे दोबारा आना चाहूंगा तुषार. अब आपने इतना सीरियस सब्जेक्ट लिया और आपके जो दो हीरोइंस थे मूवी के, दे वर 60 ईयर ओल्ड हरियाणवी आई गेस लेडीज, राइट? बट यू पिक्ड
अप नॉट फॉर हरियाणवी सर, दे आर फ्रॉम यूपी.
बट आपने रिलेटिवली यंग गर्ल्स, ग्लैमरस गर्ल्स, तापसी और भूमि को इसमें कास्ट किया. तो कास्टिंग कैसे करते हैं, आपने कैसे चूज किया और कैसे उन्होंने क्या जबरदस्त एक्टिंग करी? उसमें डायरेक्टर और एक्टर का कितना रोल रहता है मूवी में करेक्टर के अंदर जाने में और उसको सक्सेसफुल करने में?
सर एक्चुअली
हम जाना
ये क्वेश्चन मैंने आई थिंक लास्ट टाइम आंसर कर चुका हूँ, क्योंकि ये ऑल्सो कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी बन गया था. Why I casted younger heroines and not older ones. So in fact, I used to play this repeat mode. मैं बोलता हूँ जो हमेशा मैं same button दबाता हूँ, same answer देता हूँ. मैं भी आपको वही answer दूँगा. क्या basically ये था sir, क्या like I said, movie जब बनती है जब पर्दे पे आती है. People have to understand that. Otherwise, हम picture बना के घर पे रेड के release नहीं होगी तो फायदा ही नहीं उसका, right? And movies have to be released. Then it is that's the fun of making a movie. So when I started off to make Sant Ki Aankh, yes, we had thought of casting older ladies and older actresses, which would have been ideal for it. I don't deny that. But when I went out in the market, Nidhi and me, like we didn't have the money to make the movie. We needed a producer. We got Anurag Kashyap on board. But just by getting, we wanted to cast older women, but no one would give me that budget, because if you've seen the way the movie is made, it requires a certain amount of a budget to make a movie. And I was not getting the budget. So unfortunately, I had no option. But then I had to cast younger heroines where at least they would, I would get a certain amount of budget to make the film. So it took me 5 years to do the casting. It was not easy. There were a lot of, because there were a lot of people who were very scared to do the film, the heroines. I in fact went to every heroine in the industry. But everyone liked the subject, but there were different issues. Maybe because I was the first time director, and many people said it's a very hard film that you're making. It's a very difficult film. So I was very surprised. I said, I don't mind. What do you mean by easy film or difficult? Every film is difficult. And I want to make a good film. It's nothing called a difficult film. So I just knew that it was a good film. And I didn't give up hope for 5 years. And that's because of Nidhi, my wife, backing me. She backed me a lot. And this is because of her that I could stay. Because there were a lot of frustrating days where the movie started and the movie stopped. Suddenly there was an actress who came on board and left the movie. So there were a lot of hardships to the movie. But we never gave up. And we stood there and together. And somehow she kept on supporting me. And we went ahead and made this movie. And the best, I can always say, these Bhumi and Tapsee are the only two girls who had the balls to do the movie. Sorry for my language, but yeah, they are the only one who had the balls to do this movie. And I think they were the best choice. And I could have never got a better choice than Bhumi and Tapsee. And it's now it's out in the open and you can see the awards they won. Almost won every place they've always, in all the awards they've won it together, which is a great thing for me.
I think it was a fantastic, fantastic cast. Like I said, I went into the movie without expectations, Tushar. Mujhe nahi malum tha, main aapko un dino nahi janta tha. I had no idea about Saant Ki Aankh, but I cried in the movie. It was phenomenal. It's about making, you know, the girl child successful. And we see so many of these success stories at Shulini itself. So hats off to you. We're really thankful for you to making such movies.
Thank you.
Pray to God कि आप ऐसी-ऐसी और बहुत सारी movies बनाइए जिससे कि हमारे बच्चे जो हैं वो inspire हों, क्योंकि हमारा belief है कि future of India जो है ये छोटे शहरों से आएगा, ये गांव से आएगा, ये लड़कियों से आएगा, ये उन communities से आएगा जो आज जिनको हम minorities बोलते हैं या castes हैं जिनको हम थोड़ा नीचे देखते हैं, तो उनको हमने ऊपर बढ़ाना है. तो hats off to you. तो आपके future कुछ projects होंगे इसी direction में, तो शायद आप मुझे कुछ बता रहे थे, I remember. जो थोड़ा अगर non-confidential हो, if you can tell us a little bit about some of your future projects, what are you thinking? There's one question over here which says, are you making a movie called Aankh Micholi? I don't know whether you're making or not, but tell us a bit about your future projects, what do you have in mind?
I'm not making Aankh Micholi. Actually, but this Aankh word is, I think, stuck with me. So, like my first movie was Saant Ki Aankh. So now my next movie, Aankh means eye. And I am making a movie. It's another biopic, and it's a very inspirational story about this 26-year-old man from Hyderabad, and he's blind. And being blind, how he has risen up against all odds, and he's made a life. And today he's an entrepreneur, and his company is worth 1,500 crores. From being a blind boy whose parents were making 2 rupees, he went on to make a 1,500 crore company. And if he can do it, I think anyone in this world can get up and start working. That's my next film. It's about a man called Shrikant Bola. He's from Hyderabad. And he has a great story. And that's the movie with Jagdeep Sidhu. My writer is writing it. And Nidhi Parmar, my wife, she's producing it. So we are at the moment developing it. We've got everything in place. And we're just getting it done. And we've got one of the biggest producers on board. And that's the next movie that I'm planning.
And when does it come? When do you release it, Tushar?
Because of this corona, we don't know when it will start. And because everything is now... No one knows what is going to happen, right? No one now, these days, we can't say anything. So yeah, we'll try to plan it next year and release it next year. But it all depends on when we start the film and when I get the actors.
We can't wait to see it, Tushar. And I have a personal interest because you promised me an invitation to the premiere. So yeah, I'm looking forward to it.
And you promised me something else that we can't say here.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. We will talk about that separately, right? थोड़ा सा हम आपकी मूवीज से एक सेकंड बॉलीवुड में आएंगे. तो आई वुड लव टू हियर अ लिटिल बिट अबाउट योर रोल मॉडल्स. आपके डायरेक्टर कौन है रोल मॉडल? योर बेस्ट मूवी दैट यू थिंक एवर गॉट प्रोड्यूस्ड इन बॉलीवुड अकॉर्डिंग टू यू. योर राइटर रोल मॉडल. आई लव टू हियर अ बिट अबाउट दैट फ्रॉम यू, तुषार.
सो माय वाइफ नोज दिस. या सो आई एम नेवर इनामोर्ड बाय एनीवन इन बॉलीवुड. आई नेवर गेट नो शेकन अप बाय एनी एक्ट्रेस और एक्टर और एनीबॉडी. बट या देयर इज वन मैन इन द इंडस्ट्री वेयर आई really feel that I really worship, and I keep on seeing his movies and I keep on worshipping him is Raju Hirani. And I love his movies. I love Three Idiots. I love Munna Bhai. I'm just the biggest fan because whenever I see him, my body starts shaking. And I'm a big fan of him. And I always admire him, the way he makes movies. And I love the way he writes his movies with Abhijit Joshi. So I think the team, the writing team, if you say Abhijit Joshi and Raju Hirani also is one of my favorites. So I always joke with my writer Jagdeep now that ek din main Raju Hirani aur Abhijit Joshi banenge. So that's the aim to live up to. But yeah, that's what you want. You need to have some role models. So at least you can follow them and reach somewhere there.
I think that's very exciting. Bollywood ke ek do question aapse aur puchenge kyunki hum thoda controversial hain, but aap dekhiye agar answer kar sakte hain. Casting couch ke bare mein maine bahut suna hai. Ye hota hai ke sirf magazine mein likha jata hai?
Sir, hota hoga, par main to kabhi isme involved nahi tha, to mujhe kuch pata nahi. So I have no idea and I don't get into all this. So man, you can see Sand ki ek bahut family picture thi. Halanki maine picture pehle masti likhi and I've watched all and I've come to Sand ki ek. So I don't think this happens. I don't know if it happens. If it does happen, it's a very bad thing that it happens. And I don't know anything about it. Very sorry about that.
I think that's a right and politically right answer too. And I hope it doesn't.
Hope it doesn't happen.
Absolutely. How is Bollywood spending its time during COVID? What are people doing? Are they getting more creative? Or what's the general sense? What's the general mood?
Everyone is not only Bollywood, everyone is concerned about the livelihood and the economy and everything. But yeah, now this is happening, there's nothing no one can do about anything about this. So everyone is spending time with their family. Because we always say that in Bollywood is a very fast-paced life. People don't have time for each other. They don't have time for their families. But now, with this break, there's no excuse that one can give. Even if they don't want to spend time with their family, they will have to sit and spend time with their family at home. So, it's been done. They have to spend time with their family. So, that is what it is. Spending time with the family. And that's the best way today. That's all that you can look forward to.
Wonderful. I think that's relevant to all of us.
And plus, we get to eat home food cooked meal now. Everyone is eating home food. Ghar ka khana sabko mil raha hai. Jo pehle hum rote the, arre ghar ka khana nahi mil raha hai, ghar ka khana nahi mil raha hai. Ab humko, because the kind of work we do, we don't get ghar ka khana. Hamesha bahar hi khate hum. So now ghar ka khana bhi kha rahe sab. So it's a good thing. Yeah.
So, बहुत सारे क्वेश्चन हैं ऑडियंस के. बिफोर आई गेट इनटू दैट, आई थिंक टीएम आपके भी क्वेश्चंस थे, फिर हम ऑडियंस के क्वेश्चंस में जाएंगे. व्हाई डोंट यू आस्क वन और टू क्वेश्चंस एंड देन वी विल गेट इनटू द क्वेश्चंस ऑफ द ऑडियंस.
वन क्वेश्चन आई रियली वांटेड टू आस्क वाज, व्हेन इज दैट मोमेंट यू रियलाइज दैट दिस कास्ट व्हिच यू हैव चोजन फॉर योर फिल्म, दे शेयर द सेम क्रिएटिव विजन एंड पैशन. व्हेन इज दैट मोमेंट व्हेन यू रियलाइज दैट दिस इज इट?
I'll tell you what. It's very good. This question is very good. So, forget my cast. The entire team that worked with me, Tushar. Maybe my cameraman, my writer, my art director, my ADs. So, when there's a certain amount of prize that everyone has, yeah, in the market, right? And they get that prize. And mine being a woman-oriented film, plus it is about 260-year-old women, not even a hero-oriented film, which is glamorous. There's no glamour in my film as such, you see. And it's a very, if you put it in a sense, it's a very offbeat film. Though we made it in a commercial way, but when you look at it on paper, it would sound a very offbeat film. And the budget obviously was not big enough. But the support that I got from my team, everyone reduced the prices to 1/3. In fact, I always have this joke that my art director, Mr. Ravish Srivastav, has put his own money in making the sets. And I think it's true also because the passion, the spot boys that we had, everyone, because the whole point when we started shooting this film, we shot it just next to the dadis' houses. So when the dadis came on the set, I could see in everybody's eyes that they could not believe, yes, this is a true story. See, a lot of people come on the set just thinking they're just shooting yet another film. But when they saw the dadis, I could see in everyone from the spot boy to the actors, to everyone's eyes that, yes, now we have something and they know that this is a story to be told. And that's the energy that you can see in it. It's not me alone, but it's my entire team's energy that you can see from the producer, Niti, who was there full time. Everyone was like at it.
Wow.
You have stories ki baat ki aapne, to ek do questions aa rahe hain yahan pe, Tushar. So one, and I'll ask two questions which are related to each other. One question is, someone is asking, I think one of our students is asking that, how, what is the difference between writing for a movie versus writing a short story or a novel? That's one question. And then another question which is coming up is, what is a screenplay and how do you write a screenplay? You want to pick these two questions up?
Yeah, sure. So there is no difference. See, I'll tell you, writing is something that you feel for. Writing is something that I always say that when you write a scene or you write a movie or write, if you have a body reaction, like I said, when I saw Santa, the story about these two women, I had tears in my eyes. And I always feel when you have a body reaction, you cannot lie. That's a reaction that comes out naturally. So writing is something that you feel for. And if you can't feel it, then you should not write. And when you feel for something, then you have to, like, I'll be honest with you. Earlier on, I wrote a couple of films I used to write with my head. And all those films started flopping. And then I started writing from my heart. All those films did well. So even if they didn't do well, I was satisfied with it. And whatever it did. So that's the whole point. So writing a short story or a novel or a book or a film is all the same till you're enjoying. The process is to enjoy it and feel for it. That's what it is, writing per se. And again, to answer your second question, screenplay is basically if I explain to you that the story was that today Tushar Hiranandani will be interviewed by Shulini, by Atul, and that's the story. And he will be talking about his life on Saad Ki Daak and his life. That's the story. And screenplay is what we are doing now, that this is the, and Atul will ask him this question, then Atul will ask him this question, then Atul will ask him this, then Tushar Mittal will come in. That's screenplay. And what now we are talking, that's dialogues. So screenplay is basically the entire process from the start to end of all the actions and all the thoughts that will happen during this.
So is pe mere dimag mein question aa raha hai Tushar. I'm not a storyteller, but I try to be one sometimes, at least, you know, even in our work as a consultant or as a teacher, you know, we are like actors. We are in front of a class and we're trying to act, if you think about it, right? So story narration ke different types hain. For example, if you're telling a story, I want to tell my story. There's some stories that go into flashback. There's some stories that start from childhood and as you grow old. So how does, especially in the context of a movie, how do you decide ki aapko kis tarike se story narrate karni hai? Ye intuitive hota hai ke aap kuch logon se discuss karoge ya aapka har aadmi ka apna style hai? How do you decide on that particular thing, Tushar? I think you gone mute, Tushar. I think aapko mute se nikalna padega. Haan, please.
Yeah, I got mute. Tell me.
We can hear you now.
Yeah.
So aap apna story ka style jo hai kaise decide karte hain? Uska sequence
jo hai. I can give you an example with this from Ek Villain. That's the film that I wrote and Mohit Suri was the director. And that, I think, was the first film that I started with flashbacks, like you said. Hello?
Yeah, we are with you, Tushar. Go on.
Yeah, so that's the first movie that I wrote with the flashback. And Mohit and we had decided, and it just comes naturally, actually, that, you know, we should start it by flashback. Because when we wrote it, it's called linear, non-linear. Though that's the word, that's a technical term for it. So when we wrote it linear, we realized that we need to do something and we need to, because it was not working in a certain way. And then Mohit came up with this idea to do it non-linear. And that's how we started doing the entire film, and we did it non-linear, and then it worked. So it's an intuition, like you said, it's an intuition, or it's a call you take when you realize that, yeah, kuch to chahiye. Matlab ek masala add karna hai humko. Like, aap khana banate ho, aapko lagta hai thoda sa tadka aur maar lete. That's what it is.
So, bahut sare questions aa rahe hain. Ek aapki title Sand Ki Aankh pe hai. So people are asking, why the name Sand Ki Aankh? Why not Bullseye? How do you decide on a title of a movie?
So basically, if you know, the movie's title originally was Womania. But I always knew that it's not a woman subject. It was not only about women. Of course, because these women, these dadis were women. So that was always there. But I always, like I said, I liked this idea because at the age of 65, they started their life again. And it was about shooting. It is the sport that they took, and it was Bullseye. The entire thing was about Bullseye, and the dialogue writer Jagdeep came up with this word Sand Ki Aankh. It was in the dialogue. And when he said that, I really found it very unique, and it was really apt because Bullseye means not only shooting, but in life, Bullseye means a lot of different, it has different, lot of different words, meanings to it. So you don't only use it in shooting. When you say something is Bullseye, it's perfect. So that's how we came up with this title. I thought it's the right title for the film.
No, it's a great title. And if anyone in this audience has not watched the movie, please go and watch it. I'm sure it's on one of the platforms. Netflix.
It's on Z5.
Please go and watch it. I can assure you that you will not come back disappointed. In fact, you'll come back elated with goose pimples. सांड की आंख पे एक क्वेश्चन है, कई लोगों का कॉमन क्वेश्चन है कि प्रकाश झा का इसमें काफी बड़ा रोल है आपकी सांड की आंख में मूवी में, एंड ही इज अ मच सीनियर डायरेक्टर. सो हाउ डू यू डायरेक्ट अ सीनियर डायरेक्टर व्हेन ही बिकम्स एन एक्टर इन अ मूवी? हाउ डिफिकल्ट इज दैट?
So it's a very interesting story. So like I said, I always wanted to cast. Once we started casting these girls, we wanted to cast it in a very unique way, the film. So the character of Prakash ji, we were looking out. He was the main head of the family. And we were looking for a dynamic personality. The casting director tried, but we were getting the same cliche thoughts of actors. And my wife one day suggested, you know, we should talk to Prakash ji. And he had done this. He had directed a film called Ganga Jal Part 2. Which he had acted, and we saw it and we really liked it. And Nidhi said that, you know, we should go up and talk to him. So I spoke to Anurag, and Anurag said, yeah, I'll talk to him. And we went and spoke to him. And Prakash ji, being Prakash ji, he just told him the story. That's all, Atul ji. That's all he asked for. I just told him the story about this 265 years old. And he said, I'm doing it in 1 second. And I had tears in my eyes. And I'm a very emotional person. I start crying for everything. When I get happy, I start crying. And they, Nidhi and my wife and Nidhi was there, and this guy Anurag Kashyap was there, and they said, why are you crying? Why are you getting emotional? So I said, you don't understand this, because the first film in my life, like I said, my dad was a distributor. The first film that I've ever seen in the theater was Hippe Pure, directed by Prakash Jha. And now the same man was working in my first film. It meant a lot to me. And that's when I told them that this is what it means to me. And it was great having him on the set. He really helped me out. Really, I took a lot of advice from him. And of course, I had a lot of fights with him, but it was all best for the film. He used to keep on fighting, why not this, why this? But he's, in the end, he used to always give it to me, and he used to hear me out, and he was a dream to work with. One of the best persons I worked with ever in my life.
That's so amazing. I think that's the characteristics of a great person. So we're talking about career, we're talking about success, we're talking about failure in this whole discussion. A question hai Krishanka, he's saying that अगर सांड की आंख सक्सेसफुल ना होती, टच वुड इट डिड सक्सीड, वुड यू हैव रिवर्टेड बैक टू राइटिंग? आई थिंक इट्स अ वेरी रिलेटेड एंड रेलेवेंट क्वेश्चन ओवर हियर फॉर ऑल द ऑडियंस, बिकॉज़ वी ऑल पुश आवरसेल्व्स एंड वी ऑल कीप ऑन डूइंग न्यू एंडेवर्स. सो वी ऑल एज टीचर्स वी कीप ऑन टेलिंग आवर स्टूडेंट्स दैट ट्राई 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 अगेन, बट हाउ वुड दैट बी इन योर लाइफ इफ सांड की आंख हैड नॉट सक्सीडेड? तो आपका क्या रिएक्शन होता? Would you have got back to writing? Would you have continued with the next directorial venture? आप क्या करेंगे?
I'll tell you honestly. Do you want an honest answer or do you want a political?
I want an honest answer. You want an honest answer, Tushar?
I'll give you an honest answer. If Sankhya Kya could have not worked, people would have not even taken my calls in this industry. People would have not given me any work, because I've become 45. People have said, you बुढ़ा हो चुका है, इसके थॉट्स ओल्ड हो चुके हैं, इसका राइटिंग खत्म हो चुका है, इसने बकवास पिक्चर बनाई. दैट्स हाउ द इंडस्ट्री वर्क्स फ्राइडे टू फ्राइडे. इट्स अ सैड पार्ट. यस, सम पीपल वुड गिव यू अ चांस, बट यू नो इट्स अ चांस, इट नॉट बिकॉज यू डिजर्व इट, बिकॉज दे आर योर फ्रेंड्स. फ्रेंड्स लाइक आई से, द गुरु दैट आई हैव विच इज इंद्र कुमार, हैज टॉट मी वेरी राइट थिंग, दैट इन दिस लाइन देर आर नो फ्रेंड्स एंड देर आर नो एनिमीज. इन दिस इंडस्ट्री योर फ्रेंड इज योर सक्सेस इज योर फ्रेंड, फेलियर इज योर एनिमी. That's what it is. So if this would have happened, I don't think I would have everybody as my enemy. No one would even talk to me. I don't know what would happen. So I'm really happy that we believed in Sankhya Kya, and our belief came through. And the honesty showed, and I'm getting enough work today, and people are praising it, like you and a lot of people are praising it. That's the great part, because we've worked very hard, and that's the lesson to learn, that you really need to work hard in everything.
आपको करेज कहां से आता है अपना सारा? आई एम श्योर यू पुट ऑल योर मनी इनटू इट, योर पैशन इनटू इट. सो हाउ डू यू गेट दिस करेज? आई मीन देयर सो मच रिस्क इन्वॉल्वड इन मूवी मेकिंग. वेयर डू यू गेट दिस करेज? आप मेडिटेट करते हैं कि जस्ट इंटरनल होता है? कहां से आता है करेज तुषार?
सर, मैं बहुत ही डरपोक आदमी हूँ. लाइफ में मेरी ऐसी फटती है ना, मैं इतना डरता हूँ कि मैं कोई भी बिजनेस कॉल पे नहीं रहता. मेरा करेज मेरी बीवी है, वो मुझे एक लुक देती है और मैं रूम के बाहर चले जाता हूँ, और वो पूरा वॉइस सेट सब कुछ डिसाइड करती, वो ही करती है मेरा. बिल्कुल, मैं बहुत फट्टू आदमी हूँ. मैं अपनी बीवी से भी डरता हूँ, लाइफ में भी बहुत डरता हूँ. तो आई हैव नो करेज एट ऑल. आई वंस शी गेट्स एवरीथिंग, बिकॉज़ आई एम अ वेरी फिकर, मैं बहुत इराटिक आदमी हूँ मैं, बहुत एंग्जाइटी है मेरे में बहुत, मैं डर जाता हूँ कि नहीं 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 हो रहा है, अरे मत करो ऐसा मत करो, she actually has to push me out of the room and bichari she sorts everything out for me and gives it to me on a platter और फिर मैं आगे लेके भागता हूँ उसको, but it is she who gives all the courage to me and she is the one who does it.
So there are lots of questions coming and we're running out of time. I think we've got another 5 to 8 minutes and unfortunately Tushar has to leave. He has to take his little child. Congratulations.
You can do for 10-15 minutes more, don't worry. If you're,
I'm okay. Lovely. I think we'll take that offer. So we'll go a little more technical. I think Lata is asking us a question about your biggest creative challenge in your career to date. So would love to hear that.
My biggest creative challenge was making Sandkiak, sir, because like you said, it was everything put on the line. We had a very good life going for us. My wife was working in Dharma, I was working in Balaji. I was getting a lot of money to ride. I had a very, like, मैं हमेशा बोलता था, line होती थी मेरी कि चलती हुई गाड़ी का डिक्की कभी खोलना नहीं चाहिए. हमने actually डिक्की engine सब खोल दिया by making Sandkiak. क्योंकि पूरी गाड़ी रोक के हमने 5 साल हमारा without seeing anything coming in while you are You're used to a certain life you are living and you are seeing that life and suddenly for 5 years you don't get that kind of money and you're supposed to stop living that life and concentrate on making the movie and which is happening some days and next day you know it's not happening, then the actor is on board and then the actor leaves the film. So there were a lot of, that was the biggest challenge ever for me was to make Sandkiak. And I think every movie making is a challenge. It's not so easy. People ko lagta hai ki bahut easy hai. The worst part is that hamara 3-4 saal chale jata hai. और ऑडियंस को 2 घंटे मिलते जज करने में क्या अच्छी है कि खराब है. बट एवरी मूवी दैट इज मेड इज नेवर एन इजी प्रोसेस. एवरी मूवी इज वन ऑफ द टफेस्ट प्रोसेस टू मेक अ मूवी बिकॉज़ देयर आर 1000 पीपल इन्वॉल्वड इन अ सिंगल मूवी मेड.
सो तुषार, नेहा आपको कह रही है कि सर यू आर नॉट फट्टू, यू आर एन अमेजिंग पर्सन, सो यू हैव गॉट फैंस ओवर हियर एंड आई एग्री विद नेहा दैट यू नो जो मॉडर्स्ट लोग होते हैं वो ऐसे ही बोलते हैं कि हम फट्टू हैं. So you made such an amazing movie. We are so grateful for that. A couple of more questions on, Pavan is asking, who's your favorite star? If you have to cast someone in your movies, who would you like to cast?
I always say this, that I've always been a fan of this actress called Tabu. I love from day one, when I saw Chandni Bar, is one of the finest acting I've ever seen. And I always have this wish to work with Tabu in my life. And I hope in my next film I can, because there's a chance that I might get a chance to work with her. And that would be great to have, because I really think she's a phenomenal actress and I would love to work with her.
Very exciting. So there's a question about, you started with Mann. So there's a question about saying, sir, tell us more about Mann. It's an amazing movie. If you can tell us your experience about making Mann.
So those days, it's not a great experience. So those days I was a clapper boy. Those days, I didn't even know what scene was being shot, what was happening. We used to just go on the shoot and our job was to get things for the first AD or, get pan, kiske liye pan leke aao, kiske liye bolo. So it was not a great experience. Like I said, the only thing good was that because no one wanted to give the clap, I wanted to give the clap to get entry into the shooting area. Because when you give the clap, you're the closest to the actors and you get to see everything. You're in the middle of everything. So I took that, the biggest disadvantage as the advantage, and that I think made me learn everything because I got into, when you say ke keechad mein ghus gaya main, apne aapko kamal khilane ke keechad mein ghus gaya tha clap maarte hue, and that's how it happened. So I think one was a great experience for me because that made me learn at being so close to the actors.
तो मन की एक बात और करते हैं, आपने आमिर खान जी से के साथ काम किया, हमने सुना है कि आमिर खान is a perfectionist. He doesn't leave anything to chance. He practices and practices and practices. Tell us a bit about how was it working with Amit Khan?
So like I said, I was the last assistant. So mujhe kuch itna, I could never, itna I was never close to anybody then. Unko bahut kam kaam karne ko milta hai. You're hardly on the set. So Amit Khan is a great actor and Amit Khan is a very good human being. In fact, in my movie, also Satyam Ajay, I give him the credit that I saw them and he, in fact, if you see my movie in the last, there's a clip of Mr. Amit Khan. So I'm very grateful to him more than anything else because he had both the Dajis on the show and I could get the idea to make this movie.
PM, over to you.
So I was just, asking Tushar to tell us about how Amit Khan was involved in Sandkiak, which he just mentioned. And
TM, more than that, when he came to know that we are making Sand Kiya, he called up my producer and he said that I have a lot of material on when I shot with the Dadis, and he gave me all the material also and really helped us, and they gave us the permission instantly to use the clipping and everything. And in fact, he could not make it for the movie because he had some shoot going on, but his entire family, we had a show and they really liked it and he was very happy about it. That's what I have heard.
So, एक बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन है रोहित गोयल का. He is asking, sir, would you like to make a movie on COVID-19 in the near future and talk about the achievers, people who actually helped us succeed and overcome the COVID? Would that be a topic for you at some point of time?
Well, I don't know. Yeah, it's too old. I don't think I'm capable of making a film on COVID because, like I said, I'm not that kind of a person, and it is a very dark thing. I don't know. Only the bright side about this is the doctors and the police and the nurses who are really working so hard. They actually have proven themselves as superheroes today. Like we had superhero movies, they today have been the real superheroes who are fighting and almost giving up their lives to save other people's life. And people should understand we are superheroes on earth today. They are the ones. So that's the only part. I don't know if I will be making. I have no idea till someone comes up with a great idea or writes a great film for me. I have no idea. It's too early for me to say that.
I think that's fair. Impulsive and creative people will take decisions as the time comes. I think that's probably your answer, and that's probably true. We have time for two more questions. I'll give the opportunity to TM to ask one, and then I have one question to ask, and then we'll try to close. Over to you, TM, and then so one
very simple, basic question that. What would be your opinion of that one super important quality which should be in a film director? One simple quality.
One simple quality is that he has to be hardworking. Nothing succeeds more than hardworking. Direction is a very hardworking process. The main thing is hardworking in a sense that he has to bring out the best in everybody, and that's a lot of hard work, because people might say it's very easy. No, it's not. You have to actually have the talent, because it's like I said, it's a teamwork. It's like a captain of a team. He has to inspire everybody to do his best, because a captain alone cannot bowl and bat and keep. He needs people to do that for him, and that's what it is, to inspire your entire team. And that's really hard to get, inspire everybody, and that has to be done honestly. You cannot fake today. People are doing so much work, they understand when you fake it with them. You really have to be honest and feel it and inspire them. That's the most important thing. If your team is inspired, nothing can stop you.
Isi pe ek question kisi ne pucha hai, to Shah, they're saying that a director has to be a perfectionist. There's so many balls in the air that a director has to juggle. He has to manage creativity, make sure that logistics happen, manage the actors and actresses, and get the whole thing together. Is a director a Superman?
No, sir. Director is only simple. A director has to trust his team. That is the most important I have learned in my first film. See, you take a certain amount. These are all technicians who have been doing the job, and that's how you have taken them. And then what you need to is trust them on their talent. That's the reason you're paying them. You cannot get into everyone's job and start doing that. You don't need to juggle all the balls. You have to trust them. You just need to be there concentrating and be assured that they will give you your best, and you will be seeing that on the monitor. When you sit across, the director sees a shot on the monitor. He sees everything coming into place. Art director ka art ka work, a costume designer ka costume, the cameraman, the focus puller, everything on the monitor comes together. And that's all you need to trust everybody. And we believe everybody that they will give you the best.
So this has been a fascinating, fascinating talk, Tushar. I wish we had more time with us. But aapko hum fir request karenge kabhi aapse guftgu karne ki. I'm sure,
sir.
You won't say no. Before we close, last thoughts to our audience ki times jo hain thode aajkal mushkil hain. Magar bahut young audience bhi hai, bahut sare students hain, faculty hain, aur bahut sare dusre log bhi hain. By the way, there are more than 500 people on this webinar today. तो आपका उनके लिए क्या मैसेज रहेगा एक मिनट के अंदर तुषार
सर मुझे बोलना है सबको सिंस यू हैव सो मच टाइम इंस्टेड ऑफ क्राइंग अबाउट इट एंड वेस्टिंग टाइम ऑल द थिंग्स दैट यू एवर वांटेड टू लर्न or you wanted to do, to read a book, to play the guitar, to learn things that all your life you wanted to do it. now is the opportunity to actually get on and do it. Because instead of watching jokes and things on WhatsApp, there are so many things that you, today all the books are available. Today people are giving you guitar lessons. People are giving you cooking lessons. And you can, you have so much time to do that instead of keep on crying. Now this will pass. It has to pass. Everything passes. But instead of wasting time, keep on talking about it, right? Might as well start learning and doing things that you always wanted to do in your life.
Shah, thank you. Bahut sara request aa raha hai. People are saying, my students are saying that we should please request Tushar sir to come on campus when COVID closes. I have to tell everyone that Tushar Hiranandani has already promised that. But he says it's going to be probably till around Diwali time because A, he's busy. Plus, we don't know when Corona will get over. So we'll wait to have you on campus, Tushar. We know you're a friend of Shulini University. So thank you very much. And thank you, audience. You've been an amazing audience. So many comments. I think I've been flooded with comments and questions on my WhatsApp group, on chat over here, on YouTube. So you've been an amazing audience. Once again, we'll see you tomorrow, 11:30, same time. We have the world famous architect, Saurabh Gupta, talking to us. He'll be talking about exciting thoughts about his journeys of architecture and design, about the Taj Mahal, about the magical city of Lucknow, and many, many fascinating thoughts about architecture and design. And there's another surprise for Sunday. We have a superstar, Yuvraj Singh, joining us. And I think it started with Tushar. We're now getting very famous people onto our webinar and the Guru series. So we'll keep on coming with amazing people for you to listen to. Hopefully you guys will get inspired. And hopefully some of you will also end up creating something very similar to Sant Kiang in your area of specialization. Once again, Tushar, thank you very much. Thank you, audience, and see you tomorrow, 11:30 a.m. Thank you, Tushar Mittal, for creating this, making it happen. And for others who don't know, Tushar is basically part of our creative team. He helps us in our advertisements and also an amazing creative guy. Once again, thank you and good luck.
Thank you. I'm really looking forward to come to Shulini very soon.
We look forward to that too.
Thank you so much.
Have a great day, everyone.
Bye.
Thank you. Thanks. Bye-bye.